Hey guys, Harry Thomas here, and welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to my second official playthrough on my channel. Yeah, it was, I know it was 4 months ago that I completed my first with Detroit Become Human, and today we're going to play a game from the other studio that makes, well, hit decision-based games, Quantic Dream's rival Supermassive. And got my controller at the ready. I'm sure you all have yours, and my awesome sister and future brother-in-law very kindly got me for a Christmas this a Kung Fu Panda case for my controller. I mean, it is a totally awesome. And yeah, I've got the game at the ready, as well as my Quarry mug that my best bud got me for my birthday last year. So yeah, you all know I've reviewed this game and it is my favorite game of 2022. So now it's time for me to share what decisions I made. Oh, loving the soundtrack already. To quote Linguini from Ratatouille, "Let's do this thing." Ah, the Dark Forest, classic setup for a creepy game. Oh, I love this game's choice of pop songs. So soothing. Are these guys in the car our protagonists? I would think so. Oh, the cast of this game is just stellar. Oh. Wholesome Sage, Saboah Williams, Ariel Winter, and Lance Hendricks and Brenda Somme. Oh, what road trip are we heading on tonight?
Why'd you kill the music?
I think you know why.
I don't think I do.
It begins with an L? Like the L word?
Lesbians?
Lost, Max. We're lost.
We're in geographic flux.
Right, so lost.
That's debatable.
Lost in the woods, to quote Frozen 2. Lol. Oh shit. Grab it.
Yeah, honey, nice catch.
Nice one,
Thank
Laura.
you. Man, the roads are definitely getting worse out here.
I guess it's all part of the rustic summer camp experience.
Oh, right, that's where we're going. I lost track like 200 miles ago.
200 miles ago, huh?
Damn, Saboah Williams is Laura. She is fucking
hot. You know what, Max? It's
Duh.
okay. It doesn't make you any less of a man.
You know, if Columbus hadn't gotten lost and landed on these golden shores, there would be no United States of America. Goodbye, hot dogs. See you later, apple pie.
Columbus never actually landed in North America.
What are you talking about?
Didn't even know he wasn't in Asia.
Are you serious?
Just another guy who didn't want to admit he was lost.
Well, just another guy who's got a whole day named after him, so put down your pipe and smoke it.
Oh my god. Okay, just pull my eyes out of my head, please.
I'm working on it. I'm working on it.
How come men never want to admit they're lost? I feel you, Laura. Oh, a check map.
Voila.
The map would be
what
more
is it?
useful.
Yeah.
No, but seriously, what'll happen to the normal map?
This is the normal map.
The one on the phone.
No of ours?
Of course not.
Okay, let's see. So we are... Hey, eyes on the road!
Max, you idiot, keep your goo-goo eyes on the road! Grab the fucking wheel! Wait! What? Oh shit! Oh, phew! Well, that could have been worse. Hey, did you guys see an old lady in the back of their car? I sure did. I think if it was a person, it would have called out. But how Max got his driver's license after that, I do not know.
I really have this car out.
Well, maybe it looks worse than it is?
I should check out the damage before we try to start it up again. Could you grab my, the toolbox from the trunk?
Yeah, okay.
Okay, we're no mechanics, but we'll do our best. Okay, lost in the woods. Great.
It's not so bad.
My mom's gonna kill me.
Oh, wait. Is that your mum's car? Oh. Oh, you're in deep shit, dude. If that car belongs to your mother. Snoop. Fuck it. It's more fun. Oh. Oh, he got rejected by his university.
Why didn't tell me?
Yeah, bud. Why would you keep that a secret from your own girlfriend? She could have helped you.
Yourself curling up in front of a big old fire pit singing campfire sing-alongs.
I don't think people curl up right in front of big old fire pits.
Why not?
They don't want to catch on fire.
Do you mean the campfire song from SpongeBob? Okay, let's explore. I'm tired of waiting. Oh fuck, did you see that?
Done.
You're not the boss of her.
What? You're not the boss of me.
I just don't want you wandering off on your own.
Excuse me.
That's not what I meant.
Yeah, it better not be.
I'm sorry, I really gotta concentrate for a second, okay?
Yes.
Don't doubt her, man.
I think there's someone down there, okay?
What's that?
They could be hurt. I'm gonna go check it out.
She can handle herself. Hey, anyone thinks Laura looks kind of like a teenage Barbie? I mean she's blonde.
Good idea, Laura. So thoughtful of you.
Saboa Williams would have been just as pitch-perfect casting for Barbie as Margot Robbie. Oh, are you okay, honey? Yep, she's good. Well, if we can't get the car up and running... Oh, a car! Perfect. Make sure we collect those cards because they are going to come super handy. Well, like I was saying, we might as well camp out here tonight if we can't get that car up and running. I mean, I wouldn't mind camping out here. Looks peaceful enough. Jeez, that lady is stalking us or something. Okay, this game is already creepier than Halloween Ends and Halloween Kills combined. But what was that they hit on the road? Did that have something to do with the lady? I wouldn't be surprised if it's all connected.
Where are you?
Bug! Oh, jump scare 101. Okay, my heart's in my mouth. Whoa, don't trip, love. Watch your hairs. Jump. You! Not a scratch on her!
Max? Max!
Hey, oh. Hey, why are you shouting?
Oh, phew!
What?
You tell her not to. Oh, there she is again! Matt, you tell Laura not to wander off, yet you wander
Did
off.
Did you see it?
No, but I heard something. Yeah. Let's just get out of here. Come on!
Oh, God, I thought you said you checked it.
I did check it, and it was fine. Honey, I know you're on edge, but you gotta calm down, okay?
I am not on edge, Max. I'm freaking the fuck out.
It was probably just an animal or something.
No, it wasn't an animal. You didn't see it. It was a woman.
Laura, this isn't helping, all right? Go! There we go! We're good! See?
Please just get us out of here.
Dude, come on.
Max!
I'm trying.
Why not call an actual mechanic to fix it if you can't?
We're okay. We're safe in the car, really. We're gonna be okay.
Whoa! Not the lady this time, just a creepy cop. Just...
Are either of you injured? Really, we're fine. We're just a little shaken up.
Wait a minute, he has a scratch mark on his neck. Where did that come from? Oh, something is not right.
Are you folks want to tell me what happened here?
And fun fact, that cop is played by Ted Raimi, Sam Raimi's brother. Okay, let's get on his good side.
Something jumped out right in front of the car and we didn't want to hit it, so we swerved and now here we are.
Something jumped out.
Come on, how much more honest do you want us to be?
I'm sorry, it was so dark and it happened so fast and they were gone.
Ma'am, did you hit someone?
No, God, no, of course not. You know, I mean, I don't think so. I don't
know. Sir? Keep the car running. Sir?
Is this kind of like
this is my first time.
What, like ever?
Yeah, I'm not a criminal.
Oh, wait, Max? Have you got something you want to tell us? Have you had more than one cop in your life? You commit any crimes? Well, thank you, sir.
Now, you folks want to tell me just what in the hell you are doing all the way out here this late at night?
Oh, friendly.
We're heading up to Hackett's Quarry summer camp. We're new counselors.
You're one night early.
No, we know. But we figured we'd get in early and scope it out.
Not a bad idea.
And to be honest, sir, one of us kind of oversold our navigation skills and got us completely lost.
You're not going to make it to Hackett's Quarry. Not tonight.
What?
Harbinger Motel. It's the nearest place. You can bunk up there for the night, okay?
I think we're just gonna stick to the plan, sir. I mean, Mr. Hackett knows we're coming and we called ahead.
No, ma'am, you're gonna head to the Harbinger Motel. Do you understand?
Oh, jeez. Okay, fine.
Okay, fine. Yeah, we'll head to the motel. Understood. There's just one small problem.
I forgot to spring for the middle of nowhere coverage plan on my phone.
What he means is we're lost completely.
Lost in the woods. Right, sorry, man. I had to do that.
Wait, what?
I just want to show you how to get to the motel on your map there. Okay?
For sure.
Son, remain in the vehicle.
Okay. Okay, this is creepy as fuck. Just... Jesus. He's insistent we go to this fucking motel when we're this close to Hackett's Quarry. Oh, creepy pencil lick.
Harbinger Motel is here.
Right, okay, and where was Hackett's Quarry again?
Well, I'm sure the fine folks, the Harbinger Motel, can guide you there first thing in the morning. Right. Harbinger Motel. Stay on the road.
Wait, but what if there's someone out there?
Yeah, I'll have a look. Good night.
Jeez. Well, that cop is controlling. Oh, I'm sorry, man, but we want Hackett's Quarry. We're going to Hackett's Quarry. Harbinger Motel can wait for another day. Relieved.
That guy was giving me major weirdo vibes.
The dude needed like at least a dozen shots.
Oh my god, I know.
What was up with the thing? Did you see that?
Was it blood?
Nice to meet you.
Oh man. All right, let's get back on the road.
Yes.
I think I've had enough woodland encounters for one night. Thank you very much.
Agreed. So where's this motel?
Okay, so we're here,
mm-hmm.
And the motel is here.
Okay.
But we're going here.
What's there?
Hackett's Quarry.
Yay!
How'd you do that?
I don't know. I kind of tricked him into showing me.
Very slick. Are you sure we shouldn't just get to the motel?
So wissy, Laura.
I mean, Danny, you really want to listen to the advice of some creep-ass cop who told us in the middle of the creep-ass woods to go to some creep-ass hotel?
No, that sounds terrible. Let's hit the road, shall we?
That's what I thought.
Ma'am?
Oh my god! If he called me ma'am one more time, I was gonna shove that badge up his dick. Seriously, do I look like a man to you? I got like 20 years before I'm a ma'am.
I'm sorry, but that's Laura's best quote in the game.
20s.
I could see that now.
I mean, I'm kind of into ma'ams.
Okay, we're done.
If she shoved his badge up his dick, he wouldn't have a dick left. Ah, heck, it's Quarry. Whoa.
You gotta be kidding me. There's nobody here. We drive all the way the fuck out
Max,
here.
Max, can we just look around before we jump to conclusions?
Did you actually even talk to Mr. Hackett, or did you just leave a message?
Well, what's the difference?
This is the difference.
Well, what do you expect? It's the middle of fucking night. Everybody's asleep.
I guess he doesn't check his voicemail.
How was I supposed to know that? I mean, clearly there's somebody here.
Yeah, or it's just an abandoned car and this is a complete waste.
Why would there be an abandoned...
I'll get the car.
Max, come on.
Don't
be a dick.
I'm sorry.
How come you guys don't just sleep in the car until morning? Damn, this quarry is huge. That's more than a cabin. That's a freaking hotel. Oh, information poster. Ah, the map. I'd love to spend my summers here easily.
Fun. What doesn't kill you will make you stronger.
I guess that's the theme of the game. What's down here? I know it feels like we're walking into a death trap, but this looks like the only way into the quarry. Don't poke your eye. What the? Geez, get your eye away from there. You could get it clawed out or something. Okay, that did not look human.
I'll be right back. I'm gonna get some help.
Yeah, good idea, Laura.
Max, get over here.
What's
up? There's somebody in the bunker. I think they might be stuck.
Is it Mr. Hackett?
I don't know. Just bring some tools so we can break the lock. Hey, I'm back. We're gonna get you out of there.
Hey.
Wait, what are these?
I don't know, you just said tools.
Why didn't you just bring... Look, there's someone in there.
I'm not seeing anyone.
Wait, no, look.
I'm looking, I am.
And get your eye away from there too. Yeah, gee.
There was definitely someone there.
Okay, so...
Use the hammer. Break the door down.
Can't pretend.
You sure? That's gonna be super loud.
Urgent.
So, someone's trapped.
Sweet.
Wow, that was super loud.
You go, Lady Four. Yeah. Okay, just keep the hammers and wretch close.
You've seen the evil dance.
Hello? Are you hurt?
You exist?
I mean, I know Max may be bossy, but at least he cares about her. What was that? Oh, I don't like this. Ian? A collar? Oh, like a dog's collar? Oh, OMG. Okay, we're getting the fuck out of here.
Max?
Okay, get the fuck back to the car, you guys.
Maybe it was a possum or something.
No, there was someone here.
Do possums make skeletons?
It's been kind of a night, you know?
I don't think so.
Let's just get to the motel. We can come back here first thing in the morning. We can check everything out, but... I mean, you must be exhausted. I know I am. I think our imagination...
Max!
Max!
Okay, is that a werewolf? Because think about it. Jeez! Oh, fuck, he's been bitten.
Max!
What else could it be? I mean, the collar, the fact that it's the middle of the night, it's the only explanation. Okay, help Max. Get him up the stairs before he's werewolf supper. Jeez, he looks heavy. Also, that was all in vain. He falls. Laura! No! That cop followed us all the way here?
Does this look like the goddamn Harbinger Motel to you?
Oh boy. He's pissed that we disobeys. Like Mufasa telling Simba, you deliberately disobeyed me. Our game. This is hardly the time for a cheerful song. We don't know if Laura and Max are okay. But what a epic prologue. Goosebumps. Oh, hey. Oh, where are we now? Oh, we've got to have a crow in every, spook.
Hello,
oh.
My friend. Welcome to the show. We are friends, aren't we? I've waited for you. I've waited. Yes.
She looks exactly
so
like...
So I do hope our time together proves enlightening.
The old lady who stalked Laura and Max, doesn't she?
I'm here to help you. Think of me as your guide into the unknown. It's exciting, yes, and terrifying. But if you're brave enough, if you let me help you, I can help you. We can help each other.
But if she's here to help us, we can trust her.
This is the card you found. The fool. I wonder who this is. We all know a fool when we see one, don't we? Innocence and freedom. all recklessness and risk-taking, spontaneity, actions without thought, but the consequences to match. Think, and don't get burnt. I can show you more if you'd like me to.
Oh, yes, please.
This is what might come to pass. A possible future. A path yet unchosen.
Oh, so she's a fortune teller. Oh, that guy.
There are secrets out there, you know. Secrets and lies. Paths to uncover, on which I can shed light, if you let me. Help me help you. And remember, what doesn't kill you will make you stronger.
Just like what Laura read on the sign. Whoa, I mean, I would happily, have my summer holiday at Hackett's Quarry if it wasn't for all the creepy shit going on there. And there's that prologue flawlessly, lays the groundwork for all the questions that have yet to be answered in the game. You know, what was that werewolf creature? I mean, who is that creepy cop, and who is that old lady who can foresee the future? I mean, all will soon be revealed, I am sure, but I just pray Laura and Max are okay. I'm sure they are. I mean, it didn't look like they died. If this is the first supermassive prologue where our protagonists don't die, then it's the best one by far, and they finally learnt their lesson. So thank you guys all for watching. I love you so much, and I'll see you all in part two.